I, Vinay Kumar Srivastava, is going to explain about the chapter motion. It is chapter number 8. It is for class 9. It is lesson number 1. It is lecture number 11. Today's topic which is going to explain for derivation of the third equation of motion, that is what v square minus u square is equals to 2as, with the help of the graph circular motion and uniform circular motion, and which have one thing more, centripetal acceleration and centripetal force. So here I am going to explain. Here is the velocity, here the graph is given as the velocity time graph, and I am going to prove it with the help of the velocity time graph. It is the graph which has come. This is for the velocity. And here from O, here the graph is given, O to A, it is U, initial velocity, and A to, and O to D, it is V, here it is mentioned, O to A, it is U, O to D, it is V, and then OD, AD, AD is equals to V minus U. Similarly here, A, here it is given, EB is equals to V, and EC is equals to U, and CB is equals to V minus U. Here this is the time axis, OX is the time axis, OT it is equals to E, OE is equals to T, as well as AC is equals to T. So AC is equals to OE is equals to T. So this is I am going to explain with the help of this. We know that already the area of trapezium is half into sum of the parallel sides and distance between the two parallel sides. So the area of the trapezium, here it is given OABE, OABE, here is OABE, this is the trapezium, and then we have to find out the area between them. These are the two parallel sides. Here the area, it is S is equals to half into OA plus EB into AC. Then it is again written S is equals to half into OA, EB it is equals to OD, here it is given EB, that is equals to OD, both are similar, the value of them is V. And here is AC, it is given AC, it is equals to OE, AC, here is C, AC, it is equals to OE, the value of AC is equals to OE is equals to T. So here I am going to change that, EB is equals to OD and AC is equals to OE, so S is equals to half into OA into OD into OE. So this is first equation of motion, and on substituting OA is equals to U, it is given OA is equals to U, OD is equals to V, OD is equals to V. We have to put, and here it is given OE is equals to T, it is given here OE equals to T in the relation 1. So we have S is equals to half into U plus V into T. This is second equation of motion. And then second equation, then from velocity time relation, we know that the formula V is equals to U plus AT. So we can write it AT is equals to V minus U. To make a formula for T, it is equals to V minus U upon A. So using equations first and second, we have S is equals to half into U plus V into V minus U upon A. Simplify, here it is V plus U, V minus U upon 2A, and then we can write S is equals to V square minus U square upon 2A. We know that A plus B into A minus B, it is equals to A square minus B square. So V square minus U square we can write instead of V plus U into V minus U. So it will become this 2A that is going to shift there, it will become 2AS is equals to V square minus U square, hence V square is equals to U square plus 2AS, or we can say it is what, V square minus U square is equals to 2AS, and this is this V square minus U square is equals to 2AS is derived. It is called, it is the third equation of motion. Now here I am going to explain about the circular motion. Already we know that circular motion is what, when a body or an object moves in a circle, its motion is called circular motion. अगर कोई body है, object है, अगर circular path में चलती तो उसको बोलते हैं circular motion. Here it is given. It is a particle. A particle, if it is at A and it is moving from A to B and from B to C and C to D. So what is the motion of the particle, which is what, circular motion. Here, when a body is moving along a circular path, then its direction of motion, it is direction of velocity, keeps changing continuously. Its direction is direction when the particle is here. If it is at A and then it moves to B, so here you see its direction is in the tangential direction, it has V, and then when it reaches B, a direction is totally changed, and then from B to C, the particle move come to C, the particle its direction is again changed, and when it the particle which is reached at D, again its direction is changed. If you can say at A it is in the northward direction, at B it is in the westward direction, C it is southward direction, and D it is eastward direction. C in the southward direction and D it is in the eastward direction. So when the particle is moving to A, B, C, D, its direction is continuously changing, because the direction is continuously changing, so it has acceleration. Its velocity is continuously changing. Its speed is constant, but its velocity is continuously changing. Due to continuous change in the velocity, it has acceleration. This acceleration is towards the center. It is towards the center. So towards center the acceleration is there. So this acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. What acceleration is going to produce in it? It is centripetal acceleration. What is the direction of the acceleration? That is also the direction of what the force is going to apply on it towards the center. That is called the centripetal force. A centripetal force direction is it is the direction of the acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. So the force it is towards the center because centripetal acceleration is which is produced in the body toward the center. The force which is produced in it, it is also toward the center. So what I am going to read here, see, okay, then its direction of motion. It is direction of velocity, keeps changing continuously. Since the velocity changes due to continuously change in direction, therefore the motion along circular path is said to be accelerated. So it is accelerated, it means that it has acceleration. The direction of acceleration is always toward the center of the circular path. The force which is needed to make a body object travel in a circular path is called centripetal force. So it is going to get the force due to this force it is doing motion in the circular path. So it is this centripetal force is produced due to the centripetal acceleration. Formula is centripetal force is equals to mass into centripetal acceleration. Now see, here it is given, if R is the radius of the circle, what the circle is there, and V is the speed of the particle moving along it, and T is the time taken to complete one revolution, that is called time of revolution. So we have to use this formula. The speed of particle is equals to circumference of circle upon time of revolution. This time of revolution which is represented by T, and this circumference of circle we know that is 2 pi r, it is equals to V. V is the speed, circular speed, and this V is equals to 2 pi r upon T. So here I am going to transpose this T there and V here, we'll get a formula T is equals to 2 pi r upon V, where the distance covered in one revolution, that is represented by T. ये D है, this D is equals to 2 pi r. We can write D is equals to 2 into 22 upon 7 into r. It is equals to 44 upon 7 into r, where pi is equals to 22 upon 7. Now after that, uniform circular motion is what? When a body moves in a circular path with uniform speed, it has constant speed, its motion is called uniform circular path. And in this circular motion, again I'll tell, when a body moves in a circular path with uniform speed, that is constant speed, its motion is called uniform circular motion. This uniform circular motion has some examples. See here, the examples are what? A piece of stone tied to a thread and rotated in a circle with a uniform speed. This is one of the example. Second example, the motion of blades of an electric fan. Each and every house has electric fan. The motion of blades of an electric fan around the axle. Axle is the center, and around the axle the blades of the fan rotating. This one, third one, the motion of the moon around the earth. Fourth one, a satellite in a circular orbit around the earth. And the last one, a car is moving on a circular path with a constant speed. These are the examples of the uniform circular motion. Just I'll tell about the centripetal force. It is represented by Cp, a force required to make a body move along a circular path with uniform speed is called centripetal force. Again, I'll read, a force required to make an object make a body move along a circular path with uniform speed is called centripetal force. It is a vector quantity. Its SI unit is Newton as force, and it is denoted by FCP. And FCP it is equals to M into ACP. What is the direction of acceleration? In which direction the acceleration is produced in the body? In that direction, this force is that direction is also the force. Force has the direction of the centripetal acceleration. So this force is called centripetal force. And where M is the mass of the body or particle, and ACP is the acceleration produced towards the center, that is called as centripetal acceleration. So it is all about the today's lecture, and the rest part of it I'll explain in the next lecture. Thank you very much to you all.